For berry knot, it's also called square knot button or just button knot. For a basic berry knot, you need 4 strands. So start making lark's head knot. For 4 strands, you need to make 2 lark's head knots. For other useful details and faster methods of making lark's head knot, you can check out the up top I button or in the description box. As you know, middle 2 strands are filler cords which always stay together. While working, think of them as one. And outer 2 strands are considered working cords. For berry knot, first we need to make a square knot. So to start, you can pick any side of working cords. I'm starting from right. Make somewhat similar to figure of 4. Take the left working cord and go over the tail of 4. Pass underneath the 2 middle filler cords held together, then out through the loop of 4 formed on the right side. Pull them up tight and secure together. But make sure you leave some space at the top. You'll get to know the reason in some time. Now we have half of a square knot. For the other half, repeat the same thing from the other side. This time, the left working cord is in the figure of 4 underneath the right working cord. Pass the same right working cord underneath the filler cords and out through the loop formed on the left side and secure it tightly. Now this is a complete square knot. Similarly, create 2 more such square knots which is actually called a sinnet of 3 square knots. Take the middle 2 filler cords and push the ends through the central gap on top, hence asked you before to leave some space at the top so that pushing through this gap becomes easier. Once the tail ends clearly passes through the other side, pull the cords tight and secure under the bottom of this berry knot yet again with another square knot. And there you have your complete berry knot. In the second method, instead of leaving space on top like the previous one, here, once you have created a square knot, now before the second square knot, leave some gap between the first and second square knot. Similarly, like the previous one, create a sinnet of 3 square knots yet again. But this time, instead of just the middle filler cords like before, here we'll use one side of filler and working cords together on either sides and push through the respective side of gaps instead of just through the central gap as the previous one. Pull the ends from the other side and secure the bottom with a simple square knot. In the same method, at times when the gap is too small and pushing the ends through them can be tricky, any pointed tool such as this crochet hook can be quite useful. Use the same set of filler and working cords on either side of gap. Push this crochet hook from behind through the gap and fish the cord with the help of this crochet hook and pull the cord. Repeat the same for the other cords as well on either sides. Once you tighten all the 4 cords, your berry knot is almost ready. As usual, at the end, secure this berry knot with a square knot. In the same method, other alternative is to use only the middle filler cords instead of both filler and working cords as in the previous one. Same way, using the crochet hook, pull each filler cord through the respective side gaps. Pull the cords and secure with the square knot. In the same method, another final alternative is to use the same middle filler cords but not through the side gaps as the previous one, instead through the center. Pull the cords through the crochet hook . Tighten the cords and secure with the usual square knot. Let's take a look at the summary of all the four methods or alternatives. In the first one, push middle two filler cords through central gap. In the second one, push one filler and one working cord together through respective side gaps. In the third one, push both middle filler cords through its respective side gap. In the fourth one, push both middle filler cords through central gap. Thank you for watching. Stay home, stay safe.